You've gathered a serious amount of knowledge on metrics. It's time to appraise the benefits and limitations of metrics when you're taking decisions. This is your Mastering Metrics, December 2019, Task 3C, in fact, your final task. While we are big fans of metrics, in other words, we are big fans of believing if you can't measure it, you can't manage it. You got to still handle your metrics with caution. While you look at those benefits of using metrics for accountability, you got to also look out for possible limitations. So some of the base theory for this task comes from your CIM Mastering Metric textbook, chapter 1, on poorly implementing metrics, which is at the end of that chapter, and chapter 6, benefits and limitations of metrics analytics. Metrics analysis. So read through that a little bit and then build your knowledge around some wider reading. Example, this Harvard article on over-relying on metrics and that Wells Fargo case study is a good eye-opener. We'll talk about that in a minute. So to start this task, talk about the power of metrics in your marketing decision-making. Bring in the authors, bring in the insights, bringing in the research where managers say how valuable a proper metric strategy is for day-to-day and strategic decision-making. This can be supported from some of the research from Deloitte, McKinsey, any relevant research company, consultancy. There onwards, highlight the need to watch out for some of the limitations. So you can do it through some authors who's talked about it, like your theory, or you could also indicate that through a case study that is relevant. So example, the Harvard case study, in fact, the case study in the Harvard article is on Wells Fargo. In banking, one key metric is our cross-sell ratio. It's about how many accounts would one customer have. That's a critical metric because higher the number of accounts, a bank's service cost goes down, as well as the customer's level of stickiness to the bank or loyal to the bank or the potential to switch because the cost of switching is going to go down because you got multiple products with the bank, cross-sell ratio. So Wells Fargo aimed for a very high cross-sell ratio, made it their central metrics for their frontline. What happened was the staff started taking shortcuts purely to deliver this metric. As a result, they ended up opening bogus accounts and the bank was wrapped by the regulators. They were fined significantly and they lost a lot of reputation. So you got to watch out for driving metrics because there are pluses and minuses. So set up the conversation with some theory, some insight, maybe a case study on the topic of benefits and limitations of using metrics in decision making. There onwards, look at the factors you should consider. So some of the limitations would include the limited data companies would have, especially companies at a startup level or a laggard level, digitally, might not have the right data, the amount of data required to make some decisions that they need. In certain extremely complex markets, you might not even have basic competitor pricing data, especially on B2B, to know whether you're outpricing yourself in the market. Hence, your decisions can be flawed. So limited data can be researched online, and you could talk about examples of how that can impact a decision, a wrong decision, maybe also show how it can impact your company, in what type of decision. So at the same time, the second factor is the overwhelming data, the big data factor. There could be a significant amount of data volume, data velocity, data veracity. We call it the five V's of big data. And if you don't have the right technology, you will never be able to analyze them and use them effectively, because it's a tsunami of data. So you could talk about that aspect. At the same time, issues of poor data quality. In most companies, some of the data is captured wrong, stored wrong, and there could be significant poor quality data that can impact decisions negatively. So even including integrating of online, offline data, integrating your internal data that you have in ample. So example, you will have your Nexus data if you are Kiehl's. But to analyze that Nexus data with some market trends, with some inflationary trends, is going to be very difficult, because some of those data might not be timely, not be accurate, and to integrate you will have problems, hence you might not be able to take right decisions. So look at those limitations of data. At the same time, talk about the benefits of using metrics hand in hand. So this is the task on evaluating the benefits and limitations, but remember to link those into strategic decisions. How benefits of metrics lead to great decisions, and our limitations could lead to poor, weak decision. Now the command word is appraise. It's the first time appraise is used in your assignment. Double check that so that you don't go off mark by going and evaluating or assessing. You got to appraise it.